Buckingham Palace, Windsor Castle, and wherever it might be, if the Corgis are around, the Queen's not far behind.
Good evening, Your Majesty.
Throughout her seven-decade reign, they were the Queen's cutest co-stars, gatecrashing official events...
I know what you want.
...stealing the show with every tail-wagging appearance, if they had tails. They were originally bred to herd livestock, but that wasn't what the young princess had in mind when she got her first corgi, Susan, on her 18th birthday. For the record, there are two breeds of corgis, Pembrokes and Cardigans. The Queen's never been one for cardigans.
Like the rest of the royal family, she is a keen dog lover, but has always shown a public preference for corgis.
The Queen has owned more than 30. She never sold her puppies, but did give some away as gifts.
They're like a floating carpet. Whenever the Queen gets up and moves, this carpet just moves along with her.
Well, there's Emma, Linnet, mother, daughter. They don't mind being parked with other people. I mean, I've got a wonderful lady at Windsor who keeps them when I'm away.
But on plenty of trips, the Queen's corgis would carry on, travelling first class all the way.
They travel in luxury. They get to live in castles and palaces.
They have their own footmen and even their own chef.
The royal corgis had their own menu. The dogs would have a whole selection of different meats, cabbage and rice.
While they lacked none of the creature comforts, from all reports, the Queen kept her corgis on a tight leash.
Exerting friendly, authoritative control over each and every one of the dogs that I saw.
But over the years, a few naughty ones were sent to the doghouse.
Corgis have nipped the royal clockwinder, torn the seat out of an officer's trousers, and bitten Her Majesty.
The last 33 years been barked at. This one walks in absolutely nothing.
Just laying on my feet during tea. It was very sweet.
We're getting reports that the Queen's corgis have been stolen from the grounds of Buckingham Palace.
The royal corgis were never stolen, but this video prank went viral. They're featured in an animated comedy.
Ever since he was a puppy, he's been the Queen's top dog.
And have become a staple of royal celebrations. The Queen's long-standing love for corgis is why they're among the UK's most popular breeds.
Just very British with the Queen.
At the end of her reign, there were only two corgis left, plus a corgi dashhound cross and a cocker spaniel. At least two of them will be adopted by the Duke and Duchess of York. Later in her life, walking the dogs helped repair the relationship with Fergie. Meanwhile, plans are underway for a corgi parade outside Buckingham Palace in honour of Her Majesty, the most loyal of royals, inspiring a new generation of corgi lovers.
They are a fascinating breed. They're short, they're stubborn, muscular thighs. They're the pricey of
the How do we know that was coming, eh?
Well, you got muscular thighs, you know. I've noticed that.
You're going to call me a dashhound. I'm happy with a corgi.
Are we happy with them going to Prince Andrew? Is that where we want them going?
Not my first choice,
careful,
Carrie.
Careful.